Turn your computer into an all-in-one creative studio with ScreenFlow. You can record your screen, create and edit video, import media, and upload directly to the internet. Let's see how easy it is to get started with ScreenFlow. Follow along as we complete a recording, do a few quick edits, then export and publish directly to Vimeo. When first launched, ScreenFlow's configuration recording window will automatically appear. You can also access this window from the ScreenFlow Helper icon in the top right-hand corner of the menu bar. ScreenFlow can simultaneously capture content from up to 5 sources. You can record desktop video from your screen or from an external monitor, and video from your connected camera, audio from an available microphone and your computer's speakers, and audio and video from an iOS device. Once you have configured your recording, hit the red button to start recording. When you are done recording, go to the helper icon and select Stop Record or use the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-2. The ScreenFlow editing window will then open automatically with your new video and audio recordings in the timeline. Once you have finished a recording or brought in an additional media through the media library, it is now time to tap into ScreenFlow's powerful editor. Let's go over the main areas of the ScreenFlow editing window. The large central area is the canvas. This shows you a preview of all the visual elements of your project. The wide area at the bottom is the timeline. This is a visual representation of the temporal length of your project. The timeline is divided into layers to manage clips overlapping at the same time. While there is no correct way to set up your layers, it is important to keep in mind that each layer will overlay the layers below it. This will come in handy when you want to add additional media to your project. On the upper right side of the editing window are the Properties tabs. These are the main editing controls of ScreenFlow, allowing you to configure each clip of your project. There is also a media library that stores all recorded and imported media in an unaltered state. Let's go through a couple of simple edits. At the end of this clip, my mouse cursor goes to the ScreenFlow helper icon to stop the recording. We don't need our viewers to see behind-the-scenes action, so let's remove that. Zoom in using the timeline magnification slider in the bottom left corner to get a more precise view of your recording. Place the playhead where you want to make the cut, then open the Edit tab in the ScreenFlow menu and choose Split or press T on the keyboard. Now we can select the end of the clip we want to delete and hit Delete on our keyboard. Now let's add a logo for the end of our video and make it fade in slowly and move across the screen. Select your image file and drag it into the ScreenFlow timeline. Let's fade in the logo by adding in a transition from the previous clip. Click and drag the logo clip so it overlaps the previous clip. You will see the transition appear where the two clips overlap. To edit the type of transition, double or right-click the transition area. This will bring up the transition inspector, where you can choose from different types of transitions. For this transition, we will choose the cross dissolve option. Let's see how it looks. The next step is to add a video action to the logo. Shrink it in size and have it move across the bottom corner of our screen. First, select the logo clip on the timeline. Go to the Videos Properties tab and select the Add Action button in order to add a video action. A yellow video action box will appear on the selected clip. To create the movement, place the playhead at the beginning of the video action box. This is how the image will be seen before the action starts. Now place the playhead at the end of the video action box. This is how the image will be seen after the video action occurs. Adjust the logo to the size and placement you want, and ScreenFlow will automatically animate the movement for you. To resize the logo, drag one of the corners or adjust the scale slider in the Video Properties tab. Now move it to the lower right corner. Let's take a look at the video action we have just created. This is just a sample of the many powerful editing features of ScreenFlow. Once we have finished recording and editing our video, it's time to export. Under File, Export, you will find many options for customizing your final project. The Web High preset is a good starting point for getting your video ready for export. This will work for most video that will be seen on the web, but it's possible to customize the presets by clicking the Customize button. In this case, I'm going to set the resolution to 1920 by 1080 and boost the data rate to 8000. For more information on export settings, go to our ScreenFlow knowledge base. There are also many informational tutorials on the resources page to get you started. You can also publish directly to popular video hosting sites from within ScreenFlow. Under File, Publish To, select your preferred destination. I'm using Vimeo. Enter your credentials and send it to Vimeo. That's how easy it is to get started with ScreenFlow.